Good morning to everyone and welcome to your physics class. So last time we had completed chapter 1, means we have started chapter 1. The ma'am which is teaching you physics before me, she told me that she has completed chapter 1. I have little bit confusion, so I have started chapter 1 again. So it's no problem. So today we will start chapter 2 of the physics. If you are having any doubt in chapter 1, you can ask me personally on my WhatsApp, or you can call me and ask me any doubt in chapter 1. So today we will start chapter 2 of physics, physical quantities and measurement. So before starting physical quantities and measurement, I want to tell you, in this chapter we will study what is density, how to calculate the density of irregular shape, and concept of floating and sinking. Okay, and in the last of the lecture we will take doubts of yours. So let's begin our chapter. So before starting the density, you should know what is volume and what is mass. Mass is the amount of matter contained in a body. Suppose this is a duster and this is a pen. So the pen is lighter than the duster because the amount of matter contained in a pen is less than the duster. So duster is heavy. Duster having more mass than a pen. Is it okay? And what is volume? The amount of space occupied by any object. If we keep this duster in a room, so it occupies some space. If we keep this pen in this room, it occupies some space. So the amount of space occupied by this object is defined as its volume. Suppose there are two dusters we keep in a room, so it occupies more space than of individual one duster. So of two duster, the volume will be more. So the amount of space occupied by any object or any body is defined as its volume. So what is density? So density is defined as mass upon volume, mass per unit volume. So density of any object will be calculated by when mass is divided by its volume. Now look at here. Density is equal to mass upon volume. If we are using unit of mass as gram, so we have to put the unit of volume in centimeter cube. If we are putting unit of mass in gram, so we have to put the unit of volume in centimeter cube. If we are putting or taking the unit of mass in kilogram, so in kilogram, so we have to put the unit of volume in meter cube. So if we are putting the value of mass in gram, so we have to put or use the volume, unit of volume in centimeter cube. And similarly, if we are using a unit in kilogram, so we have to use the unit of volume in meter cube. So now our question arises. If the question asks what is SI unit of volume, SI unit of density, sorry. If question asks what is SI unit of density, so the SI unit will be kilogram meter cube, and CGS unit gram per centimeter cube. And we can write the centimeter cube you have learned in mathematics chapter exponent and power. If we want to write this 2 raised to the power 2 in if we take this power in numerator, so its exponents will become in negative form, 2 raised to the power minus 2. सो ग्राम पर सेंटीमीटर क्यूब और ग्राम सेंटीमीटर रेज टू द पावर माइनस 3, बोथ आर सिमिलर थिंग्स. सो इन एसआई यूनिट SI unit of density is kilogram per meter cube and CGS unit of density is gram per centimeter cube. Now, if the question asks, we have to convert the SI unit into CGS unit. So what will you do? Look, gram per centimeter cube. We have to convert it into kilogram per meter cube. So if we have to convert gram into kilogram, what will you do? You will write like this, because 1 gram is equals to 1/1000 kg and 1 centimeter is equals to 1/100 meter, and that is cube. So 1/100 cube, that will be 1/1000. And the 100 cube means 1/100 multiply by 3 times, 100 into 100. That will be kilogram. And this unit is converted, we have converted into meter cube. So this one will goes to the topmost in numerator part, and this will multiply to this. Means this will multiply to 1 and this will multiply to 1. So what will be the value? Here we will write. Hundred into hundred upon 1000, and that is kilogram meter cube. And here 1 gram per centimeter cube. We are changing the CGS unit of density into SI unit of density. Now we will cancel 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 to 0. What is remaining? 1, 2, 3 means 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Means 1 gram per centimeter cube is equals to 1000 kilogram per meter cube. It is clear? Okay, kilogram meter cube. Now this is all about the conversion of SI unit into CGS unit and CGS unit into SI unit. So in short, we can write here 1 gram per centimeter cube is equals to 1000 kg meter cube. Now I will ask to one of you, if you have to write 1 kilogram per meter cube in gram per centimeter cube, what will be the answer? What will be the answer? Okay, let me ask to someone else who has raised hand. Arunima Singh. Okay, Arunima, what will be the answer? 1 kilogram meter cube is equals to how many gram per centimeter cube? Yes, Arunima.
Sir, 1 kilogram per meter cube is equal to 1/1000 per gram centimeter cube.
Very good, Arunima. Very good.
Thank you, sir.
So answer will be 1/1000, or we can write in the form of exponent is 1, 2, 3, 3, 0, 10 raised to the power -3. Why? Because it is in division form, or 10 raised to the power 3 gram per centimeter cube. So it's all about the density and its SI unit and CGS unit. Now we will study what determination of density of a solid by using measuring cylinder. Now have a look here. Okay. So we have to study the determination of density of a solid by using a measuring cylinder. Suppose you have an irregular solid, and you have to find the density of this solid. Suppose this is irregular solid and you have to find out the density. So what will you do? We have to take a measuring cylinder that is also called graduate cylinder. Measuring cylinder that is marked like this. How many millimeter marks? That is 10 ml, 20 ml, 30 ml, 40 ml, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, like this. And we will fill with water. Half of the this graduate cylinder will be filled with water. Now tie this irregular solid with a thread and gently put in this liquid. Now, after putting in the liquid, what will happen? The liquid level will rise up. The liquid level will rise up. Suppose if we have filled this cylinder up to 20 ml, and before putting, we have to calculate the mass of this irregular solid. And we have calculated this mass with the help of physical balance. Suppose the mass of this irregular solid is 5 gram. And after putting in this graduate cylinder, the liquid level rises and reaches up to 25 ml. 25 ml after putting this solid. So who will tell me what will be the density of this irregular solid? Now, who will tell? Okay, Tanisha. Okay, how will you calculate? Tanisha.
Sir, 5 ml.
5 ml will be the, what will be 5 ml?
Sir, density of this stone.
No. 5 ml will be the volume. Look, the level rises up to 5 ml. And we know for a liquid, 1 ml is equals to 1 ml is equals to 1 gram. Sorry, 1 ml is equals to 1 centimeter cube. So the liquid rises up to 5 ml. Okay? The liquid, because initial is 20 ml, and finally after putting the solid, the liquid level reaches to 25 ml. So the 5 ml is the volume of this irregular solid, and 5 ml is equals to 5 centimeter cube. Now mute yourself. Now who will answer the density of this irregular solid? Who will tell the final density of this irregular solid? Yes, Aditi.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Aditi.
Sir, it will be 1 gram per centimeter cube.
Very good, Aditi. Very good. Very good. Very nice.
Thank you, sir.
So look here. The volume is 5 centimeter cube. And what is this 5 centimeter cube is the volume of this irregular solid. And I have told you that its mass is 5 gram. And we know the formula of density is mass upon volume. Mass upon volume. Mass is 5 gram and volume is 5. This is gram and this is gram and this is centimeter cube. So 5 cancel, 1 gram per centimeter cube. It will be the volume of irregular solid. And it is the method to calculate the density of any irregular solid. Now, the second method to calculate the density of any irregular solid is the same way. But we have to study. Now, this is a container, and this container is called Eureka flask. What we do in this method, that you can see on, also see on page number 26, the figure 2.3. What we do in this method, we have to fill the water level at this spout. A spout is the outlet of this container. This is Eureka can and a spout. A spout is the outlet of this Eureka can, and we have to fill the water just below this outlet. And to calculate the density of irregular solid, we have to tie this irregular solid with a thread and gently put in this Eureka can. After putting, the water level rises and will discharge from this spout and fill in this measuring cylinder, and it will discharge and fill up to the some level, and the level up to the liquid fill in this cylinder will be the volume of this this irregular solid which we have put it in. Okay, so what we have to do again, we have to calculate the mass of this irregular solid with the help of physical balance and observe the level of water in the this cylinder. And again, we have, what will you do to calculate density? Mass upon volume. Mass we will calculate with the help of physical balance, volume the water level filled in this container, and after we can calculate the density of a irregular solid. Okay, now the third method to calculate the density of solid is by using density bottle. First we have seen with the help of measuring cylinder, second with the Eureka can, and third we will see with the help of density bottle. Density bottle. Okay, so what is density bottle? It is a designed something like that, a bottle of 50 ml capacity and used to finding density of liquid. It is a small glass bottle having a close fitting ground glass stopper at its neck. The stopper has a small capillary tube, and when the bottle is completely filled with some liquid, then the stopper is inserted and the excess liquid rises through the capillary tube and drains out. So what happens? We fill with water or any liquid in this density bottle, and after that we put a stopper, and in a stopper there is a capillary tube. After putting this stopper, the excess liquid discharge from this capillary tube outside, and this bottle is specially designed, it always contain a same amount of liquid, if you fill, suppose if you this bottle capacity is 50 ml, if you fill 60 ml, so what will happen? The extra amount will discharge, the 10 ml amount of extra water will discharge from this capillary tube after putting the stopper. If you fill with 75 ml, what will happen? The extra 25 ml will discharge. So we, and keep remember, don't fill with 20 ml. So 20 ml, so there is no extra, there is no discharge. So we have to make sure that we have to put water more than 50 ml, so the extra amount will discharge, and this bottle always contain the same amount of liquid in it. So now we will see the steps to find the density with the help of density bottle. Now the first step is, what is the first step? First we have to wash the density bottle with the distilled water, then we have to dry it with hot air, so no air drops or anything remains. So after drying, we have to measure or calculate the mass of empty density bottle with the help of physical balance. Suppose after washing, after washing it, the density bottle with the distilled water and dry it, we have measured its mass m1 gram. Suppose we have measured on a physical balance that, and the physical balance says that its mass is m1 gram. Now we filled with this water and put a stopper on it, so it will contains a equal amount of liquid. After filling with water, second step, after filling with water, what we do? We put a stopper, and if the extra amount of water we have filled, it will be discharged from the capillary tube. Now, after filling with water, what we have to do? Dry the outer surface. If some water droplets here in the surface, outer surface of this bottle, so we have to wipe out with a cotton cloth or dry it, because there will be no error in finding the density. So we have to find the density in an accurate manner. So we have to wipe out the extra water on a density bottle. Okay, suppose we have measured this density bottle and water combinedly. means after filling with water we have measured its mass, so its mass will be m2 gram. This is empty bottle mass, empty, and this is bottle plus water. So who will tell me what will be the mass of only water? Who will tell if the mass of empty bottle is m1 gram and the mass of, okay, Kavya.
What, sir, 1 gram.
No.
Sir, 1 centimeter cube.
No, it's anyone wants to try? Okay, Vaishnavi.
So we will subtract m gram from m2 gram.
So what will write here if we have to write mass of water? What will be the mass of water? M1 minus M2 or M2 minus M1?
Sir, M2 minus M1.
Very good. So the mass of water will be M2. M2 is the mass of bottle plus water. And M1 is the mass of only bottle, empty bottle. So the mass of only water is M2 minus M1 gram. Okay. Now, we know 1 gram of water is equals to 1 centimeter cube, because the density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube. So 1 gram of water is equals to, please lower your hand. Whoever raised their hand, please lower. That is Mohammed. Please lower your hand. Okay. All right. Very good. So we know density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube. And what is 1 gram per centimeter cube means? 1 gram of water is equals to 1 centimeter cube volume. Means in 1 centimeter cube volume, there will be 1 gram of water. So here mass of water is M2 minus M1 gram. What will be the volume? Volume will be 1 gram is equals to 1 centimeter cube. So M2 minus M1 centimeter cube. Okay. And suppose, now what will be the next step? We have to take out all the water and fill with some liquid. Liquid, that's like any oil, kerosene oil, alcohol, brine solution, any liquid other than water. So we have to put out all the water and dry it and put a other liquid in this density bottle. Suppose after putting the any liquid and measure it on a physical balance, its mass will be, means mass of bottle plus liquid like kerosene oil is m3 gram. Now who will tell me what will be the mass of this liquid, means like kerosene oil, what will be the mass of liquid? If the bottle plus liquid having mass m3 gram, so what will be the mass of only liquid? Okay, Ishan. Okay, Ishan. Ishan, you have raised your hand. Answer.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Ishan.
Sir, mass of only liquid.
Yes. You have to tell me what will be the mass of only liquid. If bottle plus liquid having mass m3 gram and empty bottle having mass m1 gram, so what will be the mass of only liquid?
Sir, m3 minus m1 gram.
Good. Very good, Ishan. Okay. So the mass of only liquid is? M3 minus M1 gram. And you have to take care of, you have to remember that or keep the point in your mind that if suppose take example of your water bottle. If your water bottle, school water bottle, contains 1 liter water. 1 liter water. So what is the volume of this bottle? What is the volume of this bottle? Who will tell? Okay, Navya Shukla. What is the volume of this bottle? Okay, Navya, tell me. You have raised your hand. Okay, Siddhant. Siddhant, you want to answer? Okay, Muhammad.
Sir, what is the question?
I am asking if your water bottle contains
one liter.
Okay, very good. Very good. So you have to remember that if any container contains the amount of liquid, it will be its volume. Means if a container contains 250 ml of water, so the volume of a container will be 250 ml, or we can say 250 centimeter cube, because 1 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter cube. So the volume, mass of only liquid, okay, and volume is here, volume of a container is m2 minus m1 centimeter cube. So it is the volume of water, m2 minus m1, and it will be also the volume of a container, and the container volume will contain same amount, or we can say same volume of any liquid. If suppose this is a bottle which contain 1 liter water, it will also contain 1 liter kerosene oil, 1 liter alcohol, 1 liter brine solution. What I want to say, if any container having volume 250 ml, so it will contain 250 ml volume of any liquid, or water, brine solution, alcohol, or iodine solution, anything. So what will be the mass, what will be the volume of liquid? It's same as the volume of container, m2 minus m1 centimeter cube. This will be the volume of liquid. Okay. Volume of liquid is m2 minus m1 centimeter cube, and mass of liquid is m3 minus m1 gram. Who will tell me what will be the density of the liquid? Density of liquid. Mass is given, volume is given. Okay. Muhammad, you tell me.
Sir, the density of liquid, the formula is mass of liquid upon volume of liquid.
Okay, mass upon, that is correct. So what is the mass of liquid here?
M3 minus M1.
Very good. And what is the volume of liquid here? That is the same as the volume of container.
M2 minus M1.
Okay, what will
sir,
you do?
M2 minus
M1. We will
sir,
divide.
We will, yes, sir, divide.
Mass upon?
Volume.
Volume. Mass is M3 minus M1.
Minus M1.
And volume is M2 minus M1.
M2 minus
M1. And what will be the
GCM
unit?
Cube,
what will be the unit?
Sir, gram centimeter cube.
Gram? Centimeter cube. Very good. What is your name? What is your full name?
Sir, Mohammed Siddhab.
Okay, very good. Mohammed Siddhab. Okay, that's all about calculation of density of irregular solid. Okay, or this is the method of calculating the density of any liquid, density of a liquid. The first two methods we have learned to calculate the density of irregular solid with the help of first method, with the help of, please lower your hand, Arunima, Ishan and Vaishnavi. Please lower your hand. Okay, very good. The first two methods we have learned to calculate the density of irregular solid. The first method, measuring cylinder, second, Eureka can, and third, with density bottle. With the help of density bottle, we will calculate the density of any liquid. Okay, now variation of density of liquid and gases with temperature. Now we will learn or study variation of density of liquid and gases with temperature, means on increasing or decreasing the temperature, what will be the effect on the density of liquids and gases? Look, in the solid, with the rise of temperature around 20 degree to 40 degree Celsius, there is no change in the density, or we can say there is a very small change. So we neglect this change in the solid. In 20 to 40 degree Celsius, if the temperature rises, there is no change in the density of solid, but in liquid and gases, there will be change in density. Look here. If we increase the temperature, T means temperature, and that arrow means increase. Okay, if we increase the temperature, what will happen? Volume increase, it expands. On increasing the temperature, the solid or gases, what will happen? It will expand, means it will take more volume. This volume will increase. Volume increase. And what is the formula of density? Density is equals to mass upon volume. So who will tell me, on increasing temperature, volume increases. So what will be the effect on density in liquid and gaseous cases? Okay, Arunima Singh.
Hello, sir. Sir, the density will decrease.
Very good.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. So what will happen on increasing the temperature? The volume increases, means it expands, takes more volume. And overall, if the volume increase, the density will decrease. Now we will take a simple example with numerical data and understand. Suppose at 0 degrees Celsius. Suppose at 0 degrees Celsius. A liquid having volume 75 cm³, and its mass will be 150 gram. On increasing temperature, suppose at 50 degrees Celsius, its volume becomes, because on increasing the temperature 0 degree to 50 degrees Celsius, its volume increase. Suppose its volume becomes 100 cm³, and the mass remains constant. Mass will not change. The mass of liquid will remain same. Mass will remain same. Mass is equals to 150 gram. So just tell me, it's a simple calculation. What will be the density at 0 degree Celsius? Who will tell? Who will calculate and tell me? What will be the density at 0 degree Celsius? Density of this liquid. Okay, Aditya. Aditya, tell me. What will be the density here?
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Aditya. What will be the density? Good morning, Aditya.
Yes, sir. The formula is mass by volume.
Mass by volume. Okay. Very good.
Then the volume is 100 cm³, and the mass is 150 gram. Then 1.5 gram.
No. I am asking at in the first case at 0 degree Celsius. What will be the density? Hello? I am asking in the first case at 0 degree Celsius.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Aditya, you have tried well. Let me ask you another one. Okay, Vaishnavi.
So the formula is mass upon volume. So according to that, it is given 150 is the mass and 75 is the volume. So 150 upon 75, according to that, 2 gram cm³.
Very good. Very nice. So tell me the density in the second case at 50 degree Celsius. You can answer. In the second case at 50 degree Celsius, the volume becomes 100 cm³. So what will be the density in the second case? Can you see the data clearly here? The volume is given 100 cm³ and mass is 150 gram. So what will be the density here?
Yes, sir. 1.5 grams per cm³.
Very nice. What is your name? Vaishnavi. Vaishnavi. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
In the first case, mass is given 150 gram, volume is 75. So what will be the density? Mass upon volume means 150 upon 75. 150 upon 75. That is gram per centimeter cube. Simple calculation, 75, 2 times cancel, 150, 2 gram per centimeter cube. That is in first case, 0 degree Celsius. What will be the second case? 150. That is mass, and volume becomes 100 gram per centimeter cube. Zero cancel. That is 10. We'll put a decimal on first place. 1.5 gram per centimeter cube. So we can see here, on increasing the temperature, the density of liquid or gases decrease. So we have to remember. The key point that on increasing the temperature in the case of liquid and gases, the density of liquid and gases will decrease. Now move on, that is second topic is our next topic is convection current. Look here, suppose this is a container filled with water and we started heating it. Water, the burner is at the bottom of the container, and after some time you will observe the whole liquid will be heat up. Means if you put finger at the upside of the container, upper portion of the container, you will feel hot. Means what happened, if we start heating at the bottom of a liquid, the liquid heated whole, means up at the topmost point. So how it's happened? So it's happened by the phenomena of convection current. Look here, what happens if we start heating, the liquid here will become warm and its density will decrease, because we have learned on increasing temperature density of liquid decrease. This, if the density decrease, it will goes upside, and the higher density, you will learn later, which having lower density, it will goes upward, and having heavier density will comes to the downward. Okay, so the density of water having higher than the portion of bottom point will come to the bottom and started heating. So the whole mass will be heated, the whole water in the container heated. Look once again, what happens if we start heating at the bottom of the container? Here what will happen, water will start heating, and after heating its density decrease. If its density decrease, it will goes upward, and the upward water, means the water having in the upper portion, will come lower. Now it will start heating, means this phenomena, higher density water goes upward and lower density water goes downward. So what happens here, the phenomena continues, and this phenomena is of convection current. And due to the convection current in liquid and gases, the whole amount of liquid is heated, and it attains the same temperature. Okay, now we will learn now land breezes and sea breezes. The land and sea breezes is based on the same concept, convection current. Now we will see what happens in land and sea breezes. Land and sea breezes. Here we write land. The first thing you have to remember, in sea breezes, it occurs at a daytime and it occurs at a night time. And second point you have to keep remember, that in sea breezes, the wind flows from the sea, means wind blows from sea to land, and here land to sea. Now what happens at the daytime, the sun shines and it shines equally on the land surface and water surface, but land heat rapidly, or we can say frequently in comparison to sea bodies or water bodies. Means land heated fastly than sea bodies. After heating the land and sea, means suppose this is land and this is sea water. Sun shines equally and it sun shines equally on the land and sea, but land heated faster than the sea water. So what happens if the land heated? The air here it will become warm, and we learn if temperature in the gaseous case, if the temperature increases, its density becomes less. So it becomes lighter. Its density becomes less, so it becomes lighter and goes towards the sea, because due to the pressure drop, it rises up. And here is the pressure drop occurs. And to make up the pressure drop, the air from the seaside come here to the land, and this occurs the sea breeze. And in the next case, in the land breeze, what happens? It occurs at the night time. Okay, land breezes occurs at the night time. What happens at the night time? Sunsets, there is no source of heat, so it starts cooling. And the land cool faster than the sea bodies. See, so it's fast cooling here. Okay. Now it has started cooling faster than the sea bodies. Now air near the sea is warmer here, because it's cool slowly in comparison to land. So here air is warm, and this warm air rises and comes here. And after what happened? Here is pressure drop, and to make up this pressure drop, the air from the land region goes towards the sea. Okay, it's all about the sea breezes and land breezes. Any having doubts, so please raise your hand. In sea breezes and land breezes, anyone having doubt? The two things we have to remember: in sea breezes it occurs during the daytime, and sea breezes is the wind which blows from side of sea towards the land, means sea to the land. And then second case, it occurs at night, and the wind flows from land to sea. Okay, Sukanya.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Sukanya.
Sir, I can't understand what you explained now, because video and audio both is not clear.
Okay. Video and audio due to the network problem. Okay, we will send you the video. We will send you the video link on a YouTube link to you on a WhatsApp group. Okay, I have seen several times the messages pop up on your internet connection is low. So it is a fault of internet connection. Okay, Sukanya, I will send you the video link. Okay, recorded video link. Okay, Arya Mishra.
Yes, sir. Which chapter will come in first term?
Arya, in first term, chapter 1, chapter 2, and chapter 3.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, Arya. Okay. This is all about the land and sea breezes. Okay, Kartike. What do you want to ask? Kartike, yes, any doubt?
Hum log ke group mein message aaya hai.
Kartike, any doubt? Okay, if you having any doubt, you can ask me on this number. And I'm telling you, if video is not clear, 9044920018. Okay. If you're having any doubt, you can ask me about in the first chapter, in the second chapter, about the notes section. Okay, Arya Mishra.
Sir, please repeat your phone number.
9044 92.
Yes, sir.
0018.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. Okay, your next class is about to start. So thank you, everyone. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.